Hey, my friend, today we're going to talk about the Bollinger Bands Width Indicator. And this is an objective way to find Bollinger Band squeezes. And there's other ways to do it as well, but this is really a classic way. So what I have here is I'm using Thinkorswim, but this indicator is on a lot of charting platforms. So we've got, by the way, people always ask me what settings I'm using. So I'll just show you here real quick. Price on the close, standard length of 20, standard deviations, negative 2, positive 2. All right. And that's what we've got there. And then the Bollinger Band Width Indicator here. What that is a mathematical way of determining when you have a squeeze. So squeeze is defined here as when this line right here, the blue line, in fact, I'll pull that up too so you can see how that's edited. So we want to make sure we match this with our Bollinger bands. Okay, so 20, negative 2, plus 2. And then you can adjust these if you want to, but bulge length, squeeze length, got them set at 150. This is the default in Thinkorswim. All right, and then bandwidth, that's your cyan line here. Okay, and then the bulge, and then the squeeze. All right, and those are both the same color. Let's make the squeeze a different color just so it stands out for you. Okay, we'll make it red. Okay, so you can see the red one down here. That's where it's the squeeze. When the Bollinger Band Width Indicator comes down and touches that lower one, then that's saying, all right, we have a squeeze on. So one of the nice things about that is that it is an objective way to identify squeezes rather than just eyeballing it and being subjective about it. All right, so very good. Now, but that's not all. Okay, so over here on the hard right edge of the screen, and this was a trade I was considering taking. I did not take it, and I'm going to show you why and how you can stay out of bad Bollinger Band squeezes. If you've traded Bollinger Band squeezes before, you know that sometimes they go and they can be really big winners. That's the powerful thing about them. Other times, they fail. Well, like a lot of trades, I guess. But when they work, boy, they can be home run trades, even grand slam trades, because you're looking for low volatility to transition into large volatility. And large volatility is, by definition, wide range move in the market. Okay, so we've got the setup here. And as we go forward, let's just go forward one bar. Boom, one bar. Okay, so awesome. It comes down, touches the lower band. We've got a red bar, and it's still down here. So the squeeze is still on. We're looking to go short simply because that's the direction of the expansion. And then it comes down. Oops, green bar next day. Okay, didn't really go. Hesitation. Not going up, not going down, just sideways. Next one. Okay, red bar. But don't get too enamored with green and red because remember, look where the price action actually is. It's inside of that bar. So this red bar, in other words, the high is lower than the high of the previous bar. The low is higher than the low of the previous bar. So really it's inside that, really no major move. Okay, next one, again, not really a significant move down. Still no range bar. Oops, now we get a green bar. And oops, again. Now we've got a little higher low and a higher high on that bar. And, you know, oh, and now no bueno. Muy no bueno. And let's see. And then it goes up again. And it comes down a little bit. But our Bollinger Band squeeze, and that's it. That's where we are as I'm recording this today. So, yeah, failed Bollinger Band squeeze. These are not the ones we want to take. We got the mathematical setup, so the squeeze mathematically was there, meaning that it is a low volatility period of time, and that's when we want to take these. But it did not continue to move to the downside, and therefore we did not make money. So we're looking for big, big, big moves in order to make money on these. So why didn't I take this trade? Why did I stay out? And I'm going to show you right now. Okay, so charts are great. We like charts, but there are things that we can use in addition to charts that will give us a unique advantage. So let's pull this over here. You can still see the whole thing. So right here is a very, very powerful set of tools. So there's Duke Energy. And now, unfortunately, this is today, and the trade was back on the 24th, I believe, 23rd. And I tried to go back with on demand with Thinkorswim, but it didn't pull up the column put sizzle index. But I wrote it down because, like I said, I was looking to take this trade. And so I actually made notes in my trading log. And then even when I don't take a trade, I still watch it. And I make notes of different things, and then I watch to see what factors carried into it that made it succeed or fail. The reason I didn't take this trade was because on the day of the trade, the call sizzle index, right there, let me expand this out so you can see all the words, call sizzle index on Duke, that was, looking at my notes over here, 17.23. That is huge. Huge. So anything above one starts to get significant. What it basically means is there were a lot of large calls being placed that day. And call is a bullish sentiment for the market on options. So, wow, that's a lot. 17.23 was the call sizzle index. And even one or two or three or four, I'm not that concerned about. That's not significant enough. But when you get up to, wow, 17, then yeah, that's big money. That's professional money. All right. That's the smart money coming in. That's power. That's strength betting on the bullish side. So that's why I did not go short here. Sure, had a legitimate Bollinger Band squeeze going short, but where is the money? Where's the smart money going? Well, they are bullish, and I don't want to trade against the smart money. And, right, because if you bet it, why would you do that? Wouldn't you rather trade the smart money? Go with the flow, go with the money flow, literally. You know, they say go in the flow with life. Well, it applies to trading as well. Just go with the flow. Go with the money flow. Go with the smart money. Don't go with the, we'll just say unsmart money or not as smart money. And that's the beautiful thing about options is that there's no dark pools in options. So when we look at this, we can actually see where the big money is. Now, call sizzle today 1.3. That's not a big deal. And the put sizzle 1.29. Nothing, I don't care about that. By the way, another thing I will look at, a little extra pro tip here, didn't plan on telling you this, but I've got beta here. So I like to see betas over one, like two or three. And that is the relationship of the movement of the individual stock to the S&P 500. If it's over one, that means that its volatility is greater than that of the S&P 500 in recent times. And therefore, we can look for a big move. Again, on these Bollinger Band squeeze trades, we are looking for big moves. So we want to see big money in the direction of the trade and not big money in the opposite direction of the trade. And we want to see it outperforming the S&P 500. So there's your tips for the day. By the way, I'm giving away one of my options courses for free right now and love to have you check that out. Go get it. 3 videos, and they're very in-depth. There's stuff like this. I go deeper into the sizzle indexes and some of these things that are behind the charts that only work for options, that make options even, in my opinion, a better market and a higher probability market to trade than straight stocks, futures, or Forex. In fact, in that 3 video series, I'll be covering some of this, but deeper, how to trade with the smart money. That's in the 3rd video. And that's the beautiful thing. Options, more transparent, things you can look at behind just the charts to actually see where the big money is. So go check it out. Oh, by the way, it's freeoptionscourse.com, and it should be up there right now. So go to freeoptionscourse.com, check it out, and enjoy.